In this screencast, we're going to work through a diffusion problem where we work in spherical coordinates. And so looking at our problem statement, we have uranium hexafluoride that's being prepared by exposing pure uranium pellets to fluorine gas at 1,000 Kelvin in 1 atmosphere. The molecular diffusion of fluorine to the pellet surface is thought to be the controlling step. The reaction shown here occurs irreversibly and instantaneously on the surface, and the diffusivity of the fluorine gas through the uranium hexafluoride gas is 0.3 centimeters squared per second at this temperature and pressure. Far away from the pellet, the gas is basically entirely fluorine. So for this problem, we want to determine the moles per time, the production of uranium hexafluoride that is produced when the pellet's diameter is 0.5 centimeters. We're given a gas constant value that we may use. First place we're going to start is by drawing a diagram. So we have a spherical pellet. This is uranium. We're working in spherical coordinates, so I'm going to label our radial direction little r. We have some radius big R. And we know that we have fluorine gas that diffuses to the surface and the uranium hexafluoride that diffuses away. So the second thing we want to do is fill in what we know. Now, since we're interested in the uranium hexafluoride, I'm going to call that species A and refer to that as we move forward in subscript form. And the last thing I like doing before we start really working on the problem is our system behavior. And in this case, we look at this problem statement and we know that we're looking at uranium hexafluoride and it's not a function of theta or phi, so we're just looking in the radial direction, and really we're looking at a change in concentration in that radial direction. So we're looking at the flux of A away from the surface. We also know that in this case we're going to assume steady state behavior, and we have no reaction in the gas space. So even though there's a reaction on the surface, we care about the flux away from the surface. So within the space that we're interested in, there's no reaction going on. So I like to start our mass transfer problems with the continuity equation. So here's our continuity equation in spherical coordinates. And so we start writing down the things we're going to assume or use in our problem to simplify this equation. And so we did say steady state behavior. We have no accumulation of our uranium hexafluoride in the gas space that we're looking at. So this allows us to get rid of this first term. We know that the flux is not a function of theta or phi, so that allows us to get rid of any term that we're looking at as a function of theta or as a function of phi. We have a reaction at the surface, not in our gas film, so this term is zero. So as you can see at this point, what we're left with is this first term inside the parentheses, and so we have 1 over r squared ddr r squared times the flux of A in the r direction set equal to 0. This allows us to get rid of the r squared, and this is what's left of our continuity equation. And when we're down to this, this is saying that r squared times our flux in the radial direction is going to be equal to some constant. So now we've used the continuity equation and simplified it down, we now need to have some expression for our flux. Now if we think of our flux and our flux only in the radial direction, we could write it out as the following, where we have our concentration of our gas times our diffusivity times the gradient in terms of mole fraction in the radial direction. That's our diffusive flux part of the equation. Now we're going to add the bulk flow component. So that's the mole fraction of A times the flux of A plus the flux of B. So in this case, we're looking at fluorine being our component B. Now what we want to do is rewrite our flux of B in terms of A so we can combine them together and simplify this equation. So if we go back to our picture, you can see that our flux of A, for every 1 mole of A that's fluxing away from the surface of the particle, we have 3 moles of fluorine that has to come to the particle to react. So our flux of B, in this case, is going to be 3 times that of A and in the opposite direction. So we say the flux of B in the radial direction is -3 times that of A. So now we can plug this in to the parentheses. And if we simplify this, this becomes negative 2 times the flux of A. So at this point, we're going to simplify this further, bring this to this side, and again get it back into an equation that starts with the flux of A. So now we have our flux expression for A in the radial direction. So at this point, we want to combine what we have from our flux equation and what we have from our continuity equation. So from our continuity equation, we said that R squared times our flux in the radial direction had to be equal to a constant. So what we're going to do is multiply both sides by R squared in our flux equation to get that to be true. And what this is going to allow us to do is to separate variables and set up the following integral. We're going to bring over our R terms to the left side. Since we know this is constant, we can bring it out of our integral and set up our integral on this side. And we're going to do the same thing, assuming that the concentration of our gas and the diffusivity don't change. Then we can set up our integral here. And so now it's just a matter of choosing our appropriate boundary conditions. So we're going to evaluate the flux of our uranium hexafluoride from the surface R to a distance infinity. And we're going to say that at R, we have a mole fraction YA equal to 1, since the reaction is going to be instantaneous, and we're going to say it's 0 at infinity. When you evaluate these integrals with these boundary conditions, you should get the following equation, which now I'll simplify, which you should now be able to see, as we predicted before, that R squared times R flux is equal to a constant, and this constant is the following. So we know we have means to calculate the concentration of our gases in this film that we're looking at. We have a radius of our particle, we're given a diffusivity, the rest we could calculate. But unfortunately, that doesn't tell us what the rate of production of our uranium hexafluoride is. That tells us what the flux times our R squared value is, which is therefore some constant. Since we're asked in the problem statement to determine a moles per time, this is going to be equal to our flux of A in the radius direction times an area. Right, a flux times our area will give us a moles per time. So in this case, this is very close, but not quite. The cross-sectional area that we care about for our sphere is actually going to be 4 pi times r squared. So what we need to do is multiply both sides by 4 pi. This allows us to now calculate, filling in our values, what the rate of production, or in this case, we can rewrite this as W, is equal to 4 pi, or in this case, let's simplify it and say 2 pi times our radius, concentration, diffusivity, and the natural log of 3. So I'll go ahead and plug in our values after we calculate what the concentration of C is. We could calculate C using ideal gas law, and we'll assume that here is just the pressure over our gas constant times our temperature. This gives us a concentration of 1.218 times 10 to the minus 5th moles per centimeters cubed. So let's see if those units work out in the equation we just had. So if we use a radius given to us as 0.5 centimeters, we now have our concentration, our diffusivity is 0.3 centimeters squared per second. It looks like we should be able to calculate this out. You should make the appropriate change for the radius here. We're using a radius, not a diameter. The pellet diameter was given as 0.5, so our radius is 0.25. So when you put this all together, you should get 6.3 times 10 to the minus 6 moles per second. And so that is our production rate of the uranium hexafluoride away from the surface. Now, one thing to check is it does have a positive sign associated with it, which makes sense because we're moving in the positive radial direction. One thing to ask also is, based on our assumptions, is that even though we do have uranium being reacted with the fluorine gas, and therefore we would assume that the spherical particle would decrease in size with time, we're really looking at that diffusion path from the radius surface to a radius of infinity, and we're going to say that that's essentially constant with time. And so although we said it was a steady state, really we call this a pseudo steady state approach for doing this material balance on this particle.